They present Margaret and Barbara Whiting in Those Whiting Girls.
Working late every night till 2 o'clock at the Coconut Grove. I need my sleep. Now, come on, don't make any more noise and I'm sleeping. If you'd let me have your car to drive, I wouldn't have to get up so early to do these exercises to wake me up so I won't fall asleep waiting for the bus to get to my logics class. Don't be silly. You know I need my car during the day. Barbara, who are you phoning at this hour?
Penny, I have to find out what she's wearing. Now you get out of here. I've had enough of that. You make your phone call in the other room. I'm sleepy.
All right.
For the rest of the semester. But I guess it's just something I'll have to live with.
Won't we, Margaret? I'll move out. I'll get another room. I'll run away from home.
Maybe you could put a cot in the garage.
I don't understand why you have to get up at the crack of dawn to make your class.
Well, first I have to wake up. Then I have to stumble around for a while. Then I have to brush my teeth and shower, the usual routine. It's all very time-consuming.
It's very noisy, too.
Well, I don't know what to do about it. Oh, I just thought of the solution. Why don't you buy me a car?
What's that going to solve?
Well, if I had a car, then I could take my shower at night and talk to Penny about what to wear and then lay out all my clothes and do all the noisy things before I went to bed.
That's blackmail.
No, just a little friendly persuasion.
Well, it isn't going to work. Now, Barbara, you...
Barbara, will you see if the coffee is ready, dear?
Oh, yeah.
Mother, I can't hold out much longer. I haven't had a good night's...
Shh!
We're going to give her a car for her birthday, now why not now?
Well, first, because we don't want to spoil the surprise. And secondly, I don't think we should be intimidated. Let her be, Sly. Let her try her tricks. Let her continue the Chinese torture. We're going to hold firm.
I see. You're going to fight her with every last ounce of strength in my body.
It'll be interesting to see what she tries next.
Well, she'll probably try a big emotional appeal to our finer selves.
Ah. If I know my child and I know my child, I'll bet it's something physical.
How much?
$1. Thank you, dear.
I guess I won't have time for any more breakfast. I have such a long walk to the bus.
Bye.
Goodbye, dear.
$1.
Put it on my tab.
Barbara, dear.
Yes, Mother?
You'll be late if you don't limp a little faster.
Hi, girl.
Hi, Margaret.
Gee, Frank, the garden looks wonderful. Oh, by the way, here's your check.
Oh, thanks.
Squire Whiting passing out alms to the villagers.
Well, now I've got enough for the down payment on my new car.
Oh, that's great. Stole one is pretty disreputable, isn't it?
The old gal could use a little something.
That really frosts me. I have to walk, and she buys a car for a total stranger. Penny, I think I've got it.
What?
I'm going to shame them into buying a car for me. Frank, wait a minute. Frank, how much do you want for this car?
Oh, $20, $25, more or less.
If you'll make it less, we got a deal.
Okay, I'll drive her over tomorrow morning, and I'll clean her up a bit for you.
Oh, no, don't touch it.
Neighbors fighting again?
We were just wondering why Frank's old eyesore is parked outside.
Oh, pretty hideous, isn't it? Oh, as long as you brought up the subject of cars, this is the last chance to get me one suitable for the sister of Margaret Whiting.
Well, I appreciate that, Barbara, but this is
one opportunity I'm afraid we're going to have to pass up.
Well, relatives, if that's your final answer, I might as well drop the bomb. I've just bought a 1958 car.
1958?
Yeah, that's all I had, $19.58.
Now, Barbara, don't be silly. Where could you get a car for...
That's right. It's all mine. Frank sold it to me. Come on out and take a look at it.
Well, Mother, what do we think?
Oh, Barbara, dear, we're so proud of you. Huh? To think that my little girl has a 1958 car all paid for.
And I always thought you were a sneaky little parasite.
But I am!
Oh, Barbara, I think it's a beautiful car.
You said it was an eyesore. I heard you.
Yeah, but that was before I knew it was your eyesore. That makes a difference to a mother, dear.
You mean you're not ashamed to have it parked in front of the house?
Ashamed? Oh, no, really? Not at all. Au contraire.
I think it's rather quaint.
Are you sure you're not humiliated or anything?
Well, of course not. As a matter of fact, I'll leave my car out and you can have the garage.
What have I done to deserve this kindness?
Margaret, let's go in the house and call up a few of our friends and brag a little.
The great humiliator.
I'm humiliated.
What happened?
Oh, they don't really like the car, but because it's mine, all mine, they love it.
How can they be so inhuman?
Margaret even wants me to keep it in the garage.
Why?
Because she's so proud that I bought it.
Wait a minute.
That was probably her sneaky way of getting me to keep it off the street so she wouldn't be embarrassed. If I don't take her up on the offer, she'll get suspicious.
Of course, if the car didn't run, you couldn't very well drive it into the garage.
Penny, you have the kind of twisted mind that I admire.
You're sweet. Pick out something you like.
Barbara, darling, I hardly know what to say.
Oh, they're you, dear. They're you.
I'll wear them always. No, they can't get me to move it.
I appreciated the offer, Margaret, but I just couldn't drive the car into the garage last night. It isn't running. Something must be wrong with it. I guess it'll just have to stay out front, gruesoming up the place. Hey, Sarah, Sarah. Oh, I'll get it. Margaret, when's Paul coming to pick you up?
About an hour. We're going to have lunch at the club before we tee off.
Good morning. I wonder if you could tell me who owns that car out in front.
Oh, I do. What about it?
Well, it was out there all night. It's illegal to park after midnight, you know. I was not going to give you a ticket, but if you don't get it off the street and in your driveway, we'll have to tow it away. That'll cost you $25.
Thank you.
Well, that's all right. Well, bye.
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 Isn't that a shame?
I mean, isn't that a shame?
Penny, get over here right away and bring that necklace. We're in big trouble.
Come on. This has been a lot of work. I thought all we had to do was put those wires back in.
I hope we did it right.
Oh, sure. A car's actually a very simple thing. Now, let's see. The gas is connected to the fuel line. The fuel line's connected to the carburetor. The carburetor's connected to the radiator.
It is?
It is now.
What's this?
Press it. If it honks, it's the horn.
Gee. Doesn't seem to be any room there for it.
It's probably just a spare.
That seems logical.
Start her on up, Penny. I want to hear how she sounds.
Okay. Ow! I think we forgot something.
You know, I have no idea what a fuel pump is, but this sure looks like a fuel pump to me.
Where's it go?
Well, it obviously screws onto one of the spark plugs here.
Which one? We seem to have three extras.
Oh, well, wait a minute. Now, let me see. The battery's connected to the generator. The generator's connected to the regulator. The regulator's connected to the...
Why do we always end up at the radiator?
Well, hang on. 0-3, 0-2, 0-1, fire! Well, hang on.
Congratulations, Barb. You can hardly hear it run.
Do you think we could have done something wrong?
Hi, Barbara.
Oh, hi, Paul.
Hi. Hey, I drove one of these when I went to Caltech.
How'd you get it started?
Oh, it seems to be the problem.
I don't know. Penny and I have been working on it all day.
I think you just gave me a small clue. Oh, no, it can't. What's this bicycle pump doing in here?
I thought it was a fuel pump.
Why is everything hooked up to the radiator?
Why not?
Where's the carburetor?
Must be in there someplace.
Did you look next to the radiator?
This is it. Oh, now, this is criminal. Why, this is a good little car.
Can we do something?
No, thanks. You've done enough.
You know, Paul's right. It's kind of fun puttering around with my old clunker. Have you seen Paul?
Hi, Maggie.
What are you doing down there?
Oh, just doing my good deed for the day. Okay, Barbara, start her up.
Okay.
You just got a pretty good game
ago. I'm sorry, Maggie. I just couldn't help. Hey, what did you use to flush out the radiator?
Bubble bath. And guess who? Come on, boys, shall we? We can still play nine holes.
Thing. I know just what it is. One cylinder didn't fire, and the unused gas exploded in the exhaust pipe.
That's exactly what I was going to say.
Well, I won't be gone too long.
Don't forget to write.
My muffler and exhaust pipe. What's Paul's number?
Don't you dare. Father, are you all right?
I'm a nervous wreck. And to think that I paid you 50 cents for the dubious privilege of getting this way.
Well, what happened?
Well, sir, I think I met every motorcycle policeman in West Los Angeles. Driving with only one headlight. Then the muffler blew off. That's this one. It made so much noise that five prowl cars showed up. They thought someone was shooting up a gas station. This one. This one is a citation from the air pollution board. They referred to me as into her face.